everyone. So I wanted to talk to you guys this time about the center of our Milky Way galaxy. It's really crazy. There's a lot of stuff happening there. And the reason I want to talk about it was because there's a new study that came out recently that kind of contradicts something that we thought of prior when it comes to the center of our galaxy. So for a very long time, astronomers didn't actually know really what made up the center of our galaxy, and it wasn't until the 40s that an American astronomer named Carl Seyfried actually started doing a bunch of data collection and research on specific galaxies, mainly known as spiral galaxies. As far as the differences in galaxies, I actually go through that in one of my videos, so if you wanted to check that out, I go through all the different types of galaxy classifications. So, specifically, our Milky Way galaxy is classified as a spiral galaxy. And again, for a very long time, we didn't really know what was happening in the center. Now, Carl Seyfried noticed that these specific spiral galaxies were extremely bright in their nuclei. Like, literally, they had large amounts of ultraviolet emissions being radiated out from the central region, which, by the way, the nuclei is the central part of the galaxy. So he was trying to figure out, like, what's up with this? Why are there really high amounts of ultraviolet emissions? Even more interesting is the luminosity, which is the total amount of energy radiated from the central region specifically, was variable. And on the scale of weeks, meaning 1 week, it'll be really, really high peaks of luminosity being, you know, collected on the data. And then a week later, it might actually be like lower levels of energy, of luminosity. So there was something that was causing this luminosity to be variable and to be changing and inconsistent on the matter of weeks. So throughout more research, they started actually analyzing different things that were happening around the nuclei of the galaxy. And using the Keck Observatory, astronomers were able to look directly into the center of our Milky Way galaxy, and they found something insane. They found that the gas around the center was moving extremely, extremely fast. And then they found that the stars orbiting the center area were looking almost like planets when they orbit a star, like how our planets orbit the sun in our solar system. So meaning that you have like something in the center right here, we'll just like put a little circle dot area, and that things that were orbiting, right, it's like when they would come closer, they would go faster, and then they would go slower, then they go faster, and then they go slower, and then they go faster. Or like if there was a star here, its orbit would be slower around the central region. If there was a star here, that orbit would be slower and around the central region. But it was crazy because any time the star would pass by the central region, it would speed up in velocity. So through this, with stellar kinematics, which is just being able to measure the relative motion of the stars, they noticed that the velocities are increasing as it's approaching this central region, which means that whatever the central region is has to have a really, really high amount of gravity. So obviously, just like if you think about it with our solar system, you have a star in the central region with a really high amount of gravity, and it's causing Earth and Mercury and, you know, Mars, Jupiter, all the other planets, Venus, to actually be gravitationally bound to the star. So we're orbiting it, and the planets like Mercury that are closer to the star are orbiting faster. The planets that are further out from the star, like Uranus, are orbiting a lot slower. And they were noticing this with the stellar motions of stars that are in the center of the galaxy. So they're like, wait a second, something has to be extremely, extremely powerful there. This is when a whole bunch of more measurements were made, and they ended up concluding that there is a supermassive black hole in the center of the Milky Way galaxy. Now, the way that astronomers figured out that it was a supermassive black hole at the center of our galaxy was using the Keck Observatory. And the Keck Observatory is located in Hawaii, and it has two massive telescopes. And they actually both weigh about 300 tons, which is really crazy when you think about it. And they use something known as their AO systems, and that stands for Adaptive Optics Systems. And it's really important when it comes to taking images of space, but from here on Earth, as opposed to using a space telescope like the Hubble Space Telescope, for instance, because when you take pictures here on Earth, it's not as easy as like taking a picture with your iPhone on portrait mode, because When you're taking pictures of space, you have our atmosphere that kind of gets in the way sometimes. So they have this system called the adaptive optics system. And the way that they used to actually use it was they would locate a star in the sky nearby a celestial object that they're trying to get an image of. And they would use the motions of the star to actually adjust the telescope accordingly, depending on how much of an atmospheric disturbance they were able to see in passing in front of that star because it's luminous, very, very bright. But it became a little bit difficult because there aren't always super bright stars in like a 1% region of the sky. So this is where lasers come in. So they shoot a laser up into the sky when it excites the sodium, because there's a layer in our atmosphere where it's a layer of sodium atoms. And so when the laser comes in contact with the sodium atoms, it actually illuminates it and makes it look sort of like a star. And astronomers are able to measure the atmosphere at that moment, the atmospheric disturbances, and they're able to program that into the telescope and its mirrors, which can move 1,000 times per second. And so they actually are able to adjust it in a way where you're able to kind of have like an obstacle course around the disturbances in our atmosphere so that they can get those super crystal clear images that you get from things in space, like the center of our Milky Way galaxy. But taken with obviously a ground-based telescope. So it's really, really interesting how they do that. For those of you guys that always wondered, like, why are there lasers shooting out of an observatory that's like on the ground? Like, a lot of people wonder, like, is that them communicating with aliens or what it is? And it literally is to try and measure like the shifts because of the atmosphere. It's constantly like moving all the time. So they want to be able to measure that so that they can calculate that into the scope and adjust the scope accordingly so they can get images. So anyway, that's enough about adaptive optics. So they use that technology and they were able to not only get images, but measure the stellar motions of the stars in the central region. And it literally, their velocities were on the scale of thousands of kilometers per second, like literally thousands of kilometers per second moving in the center of the Milky Way galaxy, which means that like for stars moving that fast, there has to be something with a really, really strong gravity, hence a supermassive black hole 4 million times the mass of our sun, which is insane. So that's how they figured it out. And it's really interesting because I just read a study recently that suggests there might be around an additional 10,000 black holes found around the center of our galaxy. So now there was a study, so just one, that was done based off of data collected from the Chandra X-ray Observatory. And it was a few astrophysicists from Columbia University that actually analyzed that data, did a lot of calculations, and were literally able to detect X-ray emissions in locations and distributed where they would estimate black holes to be extra black holes in the center of our galaxy. And so they have it estimated right now in the number of like 10,000 extra black holes. And those are like solo black holes. What I mean by that is sometimes black holes may be orbiting another black hole. Sometimes too, they do have orbiting stars around them that are extremely massive and extremely bright. So sometimes you'll notice those together as well. But right now they've just been able to actually detect that specifically as a big amount of X-ray emissions coming from a region that's about 300 light years in size, just across the galactic center. And again, this suggests that there might actually be other black holes out there in the center of our galaxy, not just one supermassive black hole totally by itself. So that would be really interesting if that comes true. If you guys want to read the study, it's in the Nature Journal. So you guys want to check that out. And so that's a little bit about, of course, black holes and our galactic center. I think black holes are one of the funnest topics to literally talk about. So I just wanted to tell you guys a little bit about that. And while we figured that out. So if you guys like this video, please do subscribe and like the video, leave some comments. I do reply to all the comments. If you guys have any questions, like, totally ask me. I love talking about this stuff. Astrophysics is a passion of mine, and it also is a history. So I was a researcher for quite a few number of years. You guys want to say goodbye to Schrodinger? He says goodbye. No, isn't that right? Let's talk about black holes, Schrodinger. We'll talk about black holes. We've spoken about quantum mechanics a couple times already, but yeah. All right. Bye, guys. Thanks for watching.